Welcome to Mid-Atlantic Championship Wrestling, and you're looking at the U.S. Heavyweight Champ right there in the ring, just taking off that gorgeous robe and that championship belt, the champ, Greg Valentine. And here with me at ringside, another champion, a national champion out of the University of Syracuse just a short time ago, an outstanding young wrestler who's really making a mark now in the professional ranks, Mike Rotundo. Mike, pleasure to have you here with us.
Thank you, Bob. It's my pleasure to be here. And I'd just like to say hello to all the fans. This is my first time on the other side of the ring where I can actually sit out here and watch the wrestling going on from this angle. And I'm sure it's going to be an enjoyable hour for me, and I hope it is for the fans, too, because we have a great card lined up here.
I think I like it here a lot better than I would up there, Mike. I tell you, especially when you got guys around like the champ up there, Greg Valentine, the Hammer, and they don't call him the Hammer for nothing.
That's right. Greg Valentine is outstanding. He's got size. He's got great leg power, upper body strength, and great stamina as his father had. His father was a great wrestler. Right now he's just tying up John Bonello. He's got a strong headlock on him.
That's right, fans. John Bonello in the ring right now with Greg Valentine as Valentine lifts him high in the air right down across that knee. And Mike,
I can testify that that's very painful. Greg just dropped an elbow across the inside of his leg, another elbow.
Valentine, if he gets you hurt, he's going to stay right with it. He's going to try to put you out by staying right with the leg. He's gone to the toe hold, and still now more pressure on the leg, Mike.
He's that type of wrestler, Bob. He'll stay after you throughout the match. You can't let him have anything, because if you do give him the upper hand, he's going to take advantage of you. And that's what my philosophy on wrestling is, to take it to the man. A lot of young guys come in that I've seen since I've been in professional wrestling, come in and they hold back a little, and that's the biggest mistake you can make against a champion, is to hold back.
And indicative of just how Greg Valentine does take it to the opponent, fans, of course, is the fact that he is and has been the U.S. heavyweight champ for some time. Let me remind you right here that Paul Jones will be making his presentation to the winner of his contest a little later in the program, and that's something you don't want to miss. What a contest that's been, Mike.
That's right, Bob. Right now, Greg has a lot of pressure on John Bonello's leg. John Bonello's trying to kick him off right there. He did get him off. He's turned, but John's hurt right now. He's got to move.
He's really favoring that leg. He's
regain his balance. There's a shot to the midsection.
Look at that elbow now by Valentine.
That's the Hammer right there. That's what you're seeing.
Watch out. Through the ropes and out of the ring now. Hard down on the concrete floor goes John Bonello. He's still on the floor favoring that leg. He's taken a lot of punishment on that left leg.
He sure has, Bob. Like Roddy Piper himself knows, Greg Valentine can dish out a lot of punishment. And I'm sure Piper would like to be in that ring with Valentine right here on TV, but because of the stipulations and the laws governing the wrestling in this area, Piper's not allowed in this right now.
Valentine suplexes him from outside of the ring over the ropes. And he just cut a flip. He hit the mat so hard.
I think he took most of that fall right on his back of his neck, and I think he's hurt right now, Bob.
Right,
Valentine just turns him over and goes relentlessly back to that leg. He's got the pressure on there right now, Bob.
I don't believe Bonello's going to be able to get out of it, and he cannot.
That's it.
He says yes, as Valentine really put the pressure on that leg, and John Bonello said yes, the referee Stu Schwartz, as Valentine really showed you just how tough and rough he can be, fans. Watch it right here, the finish in slow motion. Here with us, of course, at ringside, and we've been talking to him, this outstanding young star.
Excuse me, Mr. Claddle. Wait
a minute.
This zoot suit. Where did you get that suit out of?
This is the
sale,
World
boy?
Tag Team Champions, the Briscoe.
You better believe it.
But
it's
Jerry,
our time.
Jerry and Jack, this is not your interview time, and We can't have you fellas right here. This is Mike Rotundo's time.
The world champions are here.
The world champions are here, Bob. You got class on your short. Look at this here, Mr. Rotundo. Get that suit out of two for sale. You went to school at Syracuse. You're out here trying to describe wrestling. You're just a token athlete at Syracuse. That's all you were, was just a token athlete.
They
don't even give out diplomas at Syracuse. All they give out is here, you go on the road.
Hey,
well, I guarantee you, Rotundo, you stick around. We'll show you Oklahoma style wrestling at its finest. Maybe you'll learn something. Excuse me.
Mike, I'm sorry. We tried to get him out, and of course,
There's just no handling them, you know.
You know, you would think that the world champions would have a little more class and to come out and blow their own horn like the Briscoes have done. Two guys like that that have held every coveted world title in professional wrestling in the sport. They've been great amateur champions throughout their high school and college career. And it's just too bad that they have to come out here and blow their horn like they do right now.
All right, Mike, now stay right with us.
Wrestling,
fans, we'll be back. We'll watch the champs in action right after we take time out for this session. Fans, there they are with the belts hoisted above their heads. The World Tag Team Champions, Jackie and Jerry Briscoes. We're going to watch them against Keith Larson and Rick McCord. And still with me, right here at ringside, Mike Rotundo. And Mike, again, I got to say that the Briscoes, look at this, Jack very quickly.
With a spear, double knife, double leg takedown there, just took Keith Larson down. Now, fireman's carry.
Well, he threw him out with that fireman's carry. Now he makes the tag.
Yes, these two, Jack and Jerry Briscoe, they make very, very few mistakes, Bob, in the ring. And they're really wrestling machines. Gerald just made a nice duck under, and he's riding with a tight waist right there.
Hey, Mike, I got to say, I'm a little bit surprised here. It's on the takedown by Briscoe, and look now at, at Larson trying to sit out, turn and twist, trying to
Keith
get out
Larson's
of it.
Keith Larson's showing some fire there.
Well, Briscoe's doing a good job of riding him
right
here, too, and staying right with him. But, Mike, I got to tell you, I'm a little bit amazed at the Briscoes as they come out now. Of course, Jack Briscoe was a national wrestling champion, and his brother Jerry was a tremendous champion.
They were Jack was a two-time national champion at Oklahoma State University, and Gerald was also an All-American at Oklahoma State University.
Right. And I'm just amazed at the caliber of wrestling they're doing up there right now. It looks like they're
going out.
I don't know what they're trying to prove, but they're really in their wrestling right now.
They're showing a great exhibition of wrestling holds right there. Jack's got Keith on his back. He's burying that chin down.
You think, Mike, that they may be trying to tell you something or show you something?
Well, I'm sure they are. I've also spent a lot of time wrestling amateur. I wrestled 13, 14 years of my life amateur at Syracuse University. I wrestled 5 years where I also played football. And Jack and Gerald are just combination switching in and out. Gerald with a double leg takedown again.
On Rick McCord, and they're staying right with it. They haven't thrown a punch.
Well, that's the thing with the Briscoes. They really don't have to throw a punch. But just the pressure of the gold and their egos, I think, has changed them a lot. Because they really wanted this coveted title that they'd never had before. And they, instead of going out and trying to win it like true champions, and they may have been able to do it like that, they came out and started messing with Steamboat and Youngblood. And just taking it to them the wrong kind of way. And I'm sure Steamboat and Youngblood are watching this somewhere. And I know if they see it, they're going to be itching at the
fans. It's just a tremendous showing of wrestling ability by the Briscoes, Mike.
Jerry Briscoe just had Rick McCord in a cradle. McCord fought off his back nicely.
Right, here's
Jack with a back suplex.
Well, McCord out here in the center of the ring. Boy, I tell you, Jack and Jerry Briscoe, they look like they came in the ring. They wanted to show the fans as well as
Jack
all of the wrestlers.
An abdominal stretch.
Had the shoulders just down to the mat just for a brief second. Not even a count by the referee.
He's taking him
right
in that. He's got him in that guillotine move right now. It's called the guillotine. Very painful. There's a lot of pressure on the neck, and he's got his legs tied up.
The World Tag Team Champions, fans, Jack and Jerry Briscoe, and they're really showing some of their wrestling ability.
They tag in, keep that man in trouble all the time. Gerald's hooking up a butterfly suplex, takes it back.
He's going to make another tag. They're going to switch
right
again. In and out. They're keeping a fresh man
Pretty
in the ring at all times. And McCord now is
Jack
very
picks him
slow
up
to get a heart slam. Jack Briscoe now is going to lift him
another
out of the air with that suplex. McCord has been suplexed
another
two or three
tag,
times.
Bob, another tag.
He's been slammed. They're going to switch again. Here is Jerry Briscoe back in.
It looks like to me like the Briscoes are out to prove something to somebody. Bob.
And he pins him right there. Yes, sir, Mike. It certainly does. Jack and Jerry Briscoe right there, fans. The winners over Rick McCord and Keith Larson in a tremendous display of wrestling ability by the Briscoes.
North Carolina and this Syracuse letterman,
What fine wrestling that they just saw right there. Rotundo, stick around. Maybe you'll learn something.
You just saw the greatest,
Rotundo. You just saw the greatest. Thank you very much.
All right, fans, you saw it and you heard it, and we'll be back. We'll have more right after this message. Fans, here we want to show you a portion of the action of a match between the Magic Dragon, of course, out of the house of Gary Hart there. No That's doubt right. about that, Mike Rotundo, and Wahoo McDaniel, Chief Wahoo McDaniel.
Wahoo McDaniel's been around for a long time, Bob. He's an ex-professional football player who played in the NFL for 10 years and was one of the roughest linebackers ever to play the game of professional football, and he's also carried that over into the wrestling ring because he is just a go-getter, and Wahoo's not afraid to step in there with anybody. The Dragon's got him in a little trouble right now.
Had him in that headlock. Looked like he went right with that karate chop right in the throat.
Right into the throat. Another karate chop. This Asian, Kabukian, the Magic Dragon, Hart has got him down to a science. They listen to what he says. He's supposedly one of the best managers around. Hart just got his own right there by Wahoo.
Taking a few blows. You're talking about chops. There's a tomahawk chop. And Wahoo McDaniel can throw chops with the best of them, Mike.
That's it. Wahoo's one of the best chops in the business. He's in the professional wrestling. He's got that leg right now. He's going to work on the leg, giving a little bit of his own medicine back to the Dragon. Hart's coming up. I think that's a bad move for Hart right there because Wahoo's will not hesitate to go over there and smash Hart right on the head.
Well, the Dragon backed away. He got to a corner. He's trying to get a little breathing room and a little time, and that's what Hart did.
Yeah.
Really, Gary Hart bought a little time for the Dragon right there, Mike.
That's the technique and the expertise of him.
What's the Dragon now? And this could be something, you never know what's going to happen when he goes into those moves.
That's right. That's Asian karate right there. He's got Wahoo. Wahoo's just feeling him out right now. The referee's trying to break him on the ropes. Boom. That's something the Magic Dragon does. It's out of the ordinary, Bob. It's
He has a tremendous amount of athletic ability. That you can tell by just some of the moves that he does in the ring, Mike.
That's true. That's very true, Bob. He's also got a lot of power. He's a short, stocky type build.
Look now at him trade blows.
Now they're in
They're standing toe-to-toe now, trading those chops.
Now Wahoo. Oh, there he is. There's his big Indian dance and a big chop. I think he's got the Magic Dragon in trouble right now, Bob. Ooh, a chop right across the throat. That's a chop across the eyes.
He's got him covered, two.
That's awesome.
Three.
Work.
Yes, sir. Wahoo McDaniel, the winner right there, fans, with that chop. And when he started that war dance, it was all over for the Dragon with a winner, Chief Wahoo McDaniel.
You know, we don't ask for a lot. I'm talking about Roddy Piper and myself. But what we do ask for is a few moments on this nationally televised television program to talk about two men. I'm talking about you, Harley Race, the current world heavyweight champion. You're going to be in this area. You're going to be in my backyard. You're going to be on my side of the world. And Harley Race, I'm telling you, and I'm telling all these fine people out here that have believed in Ric Flair for a long time, that when we get in that ring, Harley, things are going to be a little different. You see, in your backyard, we're not always sure we got the right decision. The most controversial decision ever in the history of the National Wrestling Alliance World Heavyweight Championship. And Harley, if I get the opportunity, you can damn well sure bet I'm gonna make sure that belt comes back home today.
Yes. Woo! You're talking about a new champion. What you're talking about, Valentine, saying all kinds of things. You're saying I need tag team partners. Well, I do. What I did is I went out and I got my friend there, Mr. T. Stands for tire iron. You see, what you're talking about is all kinds of things where I'm afraid of you. Well, you see, I got me some partners. I got me a Wahoo. I got me a Jake the Snake in my corner. No, I got me Ric Flair. You see, the thing is this. You're talking about me having all kinds of nasty clothes. You're talking about all things. Well, you see, Mr. Valentine, I seen a lot of men buried wearing a $50 Stetson and carrying a $5 gun, you geek.
Fans right now at ringside, a real pleasure to be talking with Mike Rotundo, an outstanding young professional wrestling star. And Mike, earlier we saw the World Tag Team Champions up there, Jack and Jerry Briscoe, and what I thought was a tremendous display of wrestling ability. And they may have been trying to tell you and all of the other opponents something.
I'm sure they were, Bob. They were trying to to show the people all around the land that they can wrestle any way they want. They are great champions, and there's no doubt about that. The Briscoes are. But to me, it seemed a bad kind of taste in their mouth to come out here and blow their own horn when they're not, when they don't really have to do that type of thing. I'm sure all the people in Florida have seen the Briscoes wrestle many times, and they know a lot about them, and they know they are champions. They've been champions at Oklahoma State University. They've been champions everywhere in professional wrestling. And it just hurts me to see them come out and act like that, because in my mind, a true champion comes out with a humble outlook, and he respects what he's doing. And if he has the talent enough to be a champion and to be successful, then he should keep it to himself and be humble to his fans and to respect what he's doing.
All right, and Mike, we're talking about that, and they are champions, and I'm sure they're going to be great champions. But let's don't forget the fellows that they took those belts away
from.
And they're right hot on the heels, too.
I think that's
Rick Steamboat and Jay Youngblood.
I don't think you can ever count Ricky Steamboat and Jay Youngblood out of any tag team action, because they've proven by Slaughter and Canoodle that they can take it and they can dish it out, because they came from, Ricky and Jay were almost split up. They thought they'd never wrestle together again. And they came back together and rose to the top of that ladder and became those champions. And if the Briscoes think they have it cut out easy for them right now, then I think they have a real big surprise coming in store for them.
We got a few seconds left, Mike. What about Mike Rotundo now, Mike?
Well, I'd just like to say, you know, I'm trying to improve my wrestling skills as a professional wrestler. And myself, I'm looking for champions in this area. Right, because I'm here wrestling and I'm looking to improve myself, and I'll take any match that I can sign, and it doesn't matter who it is, because I'm going to go in there as aggressive as if I was wrestling my younger brother, and I'm going to try to come out the winner, because I have always done that in my sports career, and I'm going to continue to do it, and hopefully I will be a world champion in this professional wrestling someday, Bob.
You got to do that, Mike, because the competition is just the type that you got to give it 150% every time out.
That's it.
Fans, that's it right here at ringside. Fans, and of course, that's the music. Introducing the boy from New York City himself, Jimmy Van.
There's not a couple wilder ones in the land than these two right
and
here.
And these two coming into the ring. And here comes May.
How you doing? Good day, buddy.
Get him, Daddy.
Right into the foot now of Orton. And Orton just reached up and grabbed Howard by the beard and the goatee and just held him over in the corner.
Orton with a knee to the stomach got Howard down. Jimmy Valiant pokes him in the eyes.
Mike, I think you hit it right on the head at the beginning when you said there's not a wilder pair anywhere.
That's it.
And Valiant and Bob Orton Jr.
Bobby Orton Jr. settles down a little bit now and then to put a work a hold on a man, but he's a man that has some more of the most explosive moves that I've ever seen in professional wrestling. His well-known suplex off the top rope. Jimmy Valiant's been having his problems with Kabuki and the goggles.
Howard had made a tag to Joel Deaton, and Valiant just went right over, raked him across the face, slammed him to the corner. And right into a hard right hand.
Joel Deaton is young. I've never seen him in this area before, Bob, and he's getting a real wrestling lesson today with Bob Orton Jr. and Boogie Woogie.
What a suplex that one was. He just held him at that point for ever so long, and he got a tremendous amount of force coming down onto that suplex. And now here is Valiant.
Jimmy's got a front face lock on him, picking him up for the suplex.
Right over the back, and he makes the tag. Orton in the corner.
Orton with an elbow to the back of the neck, and that's painful, Bob. Believe me, that's painful.
And Valiant saying he missed one there, as Deaton gets another hard right hand now from Orton. Orton and Valiant, two men, they like to have a mission or something, Mike. I mean, they're out. They're not going to take anything. They want to finish everything as quick as they can, and they're really going at it.
I think their outlook on professional wrestling is to take it to the other man before he gets to you, Bob, and they do exactly that. Bill Howard just took Bob Orton Jr. over. with an arm drag, wound up in the head scissors again.
Fans, let me remind you again that Paul Jones is going to be making his presentation to the winner of his contest later in the program.
I love you.
A little later in the program, that you don't want to miss. The hyper boogie man. I'm telling you right now, that guy, he is never still for a moment. Jimmy Valiant. Horton now is going to bring Howard back over near the corner for a tag. Here's Valiant.
They're working on that arm right now, Bill Howard's. Doobie goes and gives him a turnbuckle to the forehead.
Mike, we talked earlier.
A turnbuckle.
You mentioned earlier about the Kabuki and the Dragon, and I think Valiant, he really found a way to sort of slow Kabuki down, and that was with goggles on.
Exactly right, Bob, and Gary Hart's been trying everything in his power to stop that from happening, but I don't think you can hold a man like Boogie Woogie Man back when he wants to go out and do something like get a pair of goggles and wear them. Or play his music, you're not going to stop him. I don't care what you do.
That was a tremendous drop kick from Orton, who went high into the air. The double elbow now as Howard is over the ropes. Elbow drop now by Valiant. One, two,
that's it.
Three.
There's the winner's lock.
Fans, with me right now, the former World Tag Team Champions, of course, Rick Steamboat, Jay Youngblood. Fellas, I got to say, maybe you saw the Briscoes in action earlier. Wait a minute.
I've been watching them come out and
here they are again.
Excuse us. This, Mr. Cotto, let's not, you and I, exchange words. We're much too far intelligent
to have to put up with this.
Hey, Steamboat, you guys are has-beens. You never were been. It's like sending two boys out to do a man's. Bob, you have the World Tag Team Champions here in North Carolina.
Hey, regardless of who have the belt or not, we've come back several times. This is our interview time. We've been watching you guys button in on everybody's interview time. What's going on?
Well, let me tell you what's going on. It's a matter of being ex-champions and champions. When y'all were champions, this is Chief Briscoe Brothers Hours, Youngblood, Steamboat. This is our show. We are the World Tag Team Champions. You know that when you... Look at that, Jack. Look at that, would you? Hey, we're the World Tag Team.
Don't put your hands on me.
Let me tell you something, Steamboat. I've had my hands all over you, and we've got the gold straps. So let me tell you one thing again.
Don't put your hands on me, and don't get up here, and don't get up here in my face either. Don't get up here in my face.
Bob, we are World Tag Team Champions. The people of North Carolina are accepting us for what we are. We are tremendous wrestlers. Put your head up and talk a little bit to me, Steamboat. That's all you gotta do.
All right, Steamboat gave him a good chop to the stomach and one to the face, and Jerry Briscoe went right down and he's out. And now Jack draws back with that belt and he's trying to get Jerry up, and Jerry, you see him right there, he's flat on the floor. As Steamboat takes off that shirt, and Jack. All right, fans, back to action, and we have a match in the ring right now. Dick Slater, Vinnie Valentino is at the bell. They really come out.
They're in a little shoving
match
right now.
Pushing and shoving
Bob.
Up there, Mike. Mike Rotundo, fans, still with us here at ringside.
As everyone knows, Slater's been suspended just a short while. He's been back in the Mid-Atlantic area wrestling. He was on suspension because he pile-drived Johnny Weaver. And he's come back with a vengeance and that's putting him on the upper hand right now.
Look at that tape now on that right fist of Dick Slater's. He's got tape around both wrists, but he's got tape across his knuckles on his right hand.
I don't know if that's...
Oh, he's got an injury to that hand or,
I don't really
or what
know
that's
the
for.
Explanation on that, Bob.
Valentino goes down again from another block.
Right there.
Mike, another thing I got to mention to you,
and I
hope you had an opportunity to see it. Boy, I tell you, Rick Steamboat just turned the lights out on Jerry Briscoe with a couple of tremendous blows right out here while we were trying to talk with Steamboat and Youngblood.
I heard the fans screaming and yelling out here, Bob. I went outside to get some fresh air out of this hot studio. When I came back, they were carting Jack, because I saw Jack Briscoe away from here, weren't they?
It was Jerry Briscoe.
Jerry Briscoe.
It was Jerry. He was flat out on the floor, and he was out, and it took three or four of them to carry him right out. Well, and I tell you, they came in, and again, they kept just sticking their nose in and sticking their nose in, and they wouldn't leave Steamboat and Youngblood alone. And Steamboat, he gave him a couple of good chops, Mike.
Steamboat and Youngblood aren't two guys to be messing with, Bob, and I think the Briscoes throughout the time are going to learn that. And the Briscoes, like I said, have been blowing their own horn lately. This is unpredictable.
All right,
Dick
now, Slater
right
yes,
here.
Sir, you never know what Slater's going to do as he goes over the top rope off of the apron of the ring. Now he gets all of his weight. And here
Rick
is
Steamboat.
Rick Steamboat now right back out. Rick?
Bob, I don't want to butt in on your time, Mike, or anybody else's time, Dick Slater or anybody else's. But you Briscoe brothers, you're butting into our time too many times and everybody else's. I'm telling you right now, you're just going to get a taste. You just got a small taste of what's going to happen to you later on, and we are going to meet later on.
All right, and I tell you, Mike, that guy is still some kind of upset, and who can blame him? But Steamboat is steaming, literally steaming.
You know, Bill, Bob, it's a hard thing to take when you can't come out here in your own interview time and have an interview and try to talk to the fans and explain how you feel to them. Now Slater's going to work.
Well, look at Slater on Vinny Valentino. He got him outside of the ring.
Slater is an unpredictable, vicious man. Bob, I know that. I've wrestled the man in the ring.
He's like a wild man. He just almost goes berserk up there, like he just loses all control of himself. Yeah, it's like he's out of control, really. All right, here's
Valentino
now back.
He's in trouble right now. Just kicked him in the chest with that, and that hurts very much, that point of the boot right to the stomach or the chest area. Could knock the wind out of it. He goes right back to working that arm.
Working on that arm. Fans, if things weren't rough and tough enough,
takes
in the very near future right here, Mike, we're going to be seeing the Assassins. That's what we understand is a tremendous mass team. And we also hear, and I'm not sure, but it's reported that one of them, one of the Assassins, is the son of the great Bolo.
Is that right, Bob?
That's what we hear. We're not sure about that. We don't know, but that's the report that we get, that one of them is the son of the Bolo, the great
well,
Bolo,
I'm sure
and
the
they're
going
to be here very soon.
I'm sure the fans are as anxious to see him as I am, because I've never seen him in action, and I'm looking forward to it.
All right, Slater's got that arm. He just keeps pounding away right at that arm muscle.
Vinny's in pain right now.
Referee Stu Schwartz now.
Nowhere to go.
Slater to break it. But Slater, as we talked before, he's like a wild man in there, out of control, and he won't break. He just keeps going at you.
Vinny's came
back. Forearms. Hard chop now by Slater. Down goes Valentino again.
Vinny had three good forearms to Slater's head right there, Bob, but Slater has just been in control of the match for the most part of the match, and he was able to shake those off and come back and stop Vinny again.
High to the air with that suplex, and now he's got him. Oh, he lifts him up, grabs him by the hair of the head, lifts the shoulders up. Mike, now that's uncalled for. You don't want to punish the man like that. If you can beat him and go ahead and pin him, he should have pinned him.
I'll tell you, Bob, it's when someone ever does that to me, that gives me the extra incentive to want to beat that man more than anything in the world. Because that man's showing no respect for you at all. If he's has enough ability to beat you as a wrestler and does something like that, there's no way to go, and you have to get off the mat and you have to fight right there, or you shouldn't be in professional wrestling, and that's the way I feel about it. Yeah.
Slater from that standing position with that hard headbutt again down on that arm and that shoulder, out of the air.
He's got Vinny
on
up.
His shoulders.
It's an almost an airplane position right now.
I thought it was going, Mike. Ooh. I thought he might come with that airplane spin of yours, Mike. He had him in that position.
He drove him back off that. He had him in the airplane position.
Now he's got that knuckle now right into the side of the forehead.
It looks as though he's been talking to Valentine a little bit, huh, Bob?
Still driving that knuckle in. Yeah, and Valentino, I think Valentino, I thought he was saying yes, Mike, but I couldn't understand. As he continued to holler, and he did say, as Slater kept just putting the pressure and putting hard pressure on him.
I think he's been talking to his buddy Valentine a little bit too much.
The arm right there, fans, raised by the referee of Dick Slater as the winner. And Slater, who got the pressure on Vinny Valentino after really working him over. And here's where he got the knuckle in a position and started applying the pressure and applying it hard. Right on Valentino, and it was all over with the winner. Six later. And- And fans, earlier it was a pleasure for us to have the opportunity to hear from the new world heavyweight champion, Harley Race.
Chance has passed you by. You'll never get an opportunity to get a chance at it again. You were a fluke champion to start with. You edged in on a fat man, and you came out a winner. You're an absolute fluke. The man that's carrying the gold today is a man that's dominated wrestling for 10 years. And the domination is going to carry on. It started in 73, this is 83, and it's mine. It's going to remain right here until I decide to take it here and hang it up. I am, and let me reiterate again, never going to give you an opportunity to get a shot at what I possess. You were there. You weren't man enough to hang on to it. You're not going to get another opportunity. I don't care what they do or what they say. I am the man in wrestling. I control this belt. I say when it goes down the line, and I'm telling you now, Flair, that you've had your chance and you blew it. Just like you've done everything else in your life, you're blowing it. This is mine. It's going to remain mine until I decide to hang it up.
All right, fans, and here with us right now, a man that until just a short time ago suspended from professional wrestling, Dick Slater. And Dick, now back after that, I thought in that match with Vinnie Valentino up there, you came awfully close to doing some things that could cause problems again for you, Dick.
You know, I'm kind of a happy man, as you can see. You know, seems to me I've been around a lot of places, and I leave my mark everywhere I go. But a lot of places, it leaves their mark on me, too. But right there in the ring was a figment of what? Of what did you see when you see me get in the ring with Vinnie Valentino? Or any other time that I get in the ring with anybody else? Here you got Dusty Rhodes running around the South. Dusty Rhodes, you've been everything in the world, from the Midnight Cowboy, the American Dream, God who knows how many other names you've had. But you've never been the Errol Flynn of professional wrestling. But let me tell you this, you know, I am off suspension. I am alive, and I am well, and I'll give you a southern name. I'm fitting to get ready and get down. You know, you got people out here running around with 2x4s. You got people out here running around with crowbars out of their car.
I think I know who you might be talking about.
You know
there.
Who I'm talking about.
Right.
Ric Flair is another one. Well, Ric Flair, I wish you all the luck in the world regaining the World's Heavyweight Championship. But you got to realize that there's a lot of men that's going to be breathing down your neck. And I breathe heavy. Now, Flair, Piper, Dusty Rhodes, any of you. Vinnie Valentino, you want me again, you can have me anytime you want to. But the National Wrestling Alliance is going to have to stop and realize what they got to deal with. If you want to suspend me for taking somebody in that ring and teaching them a lesson how to be violent, how to be an individual, how to have a little pride, and how to be a man. If you're not a man, quit. Well, let me tell you something, Rhodes, and let me tell you something, Flair and Piper, and it goes all the way down the line. I am here for one reason and one reason only, and that is to be a winner at all costs. I don't care what it takes, and I don't care what kind of people think about me, because it just doesn't matter. Nothing matters but me being what I want to be, and that is a winner, and I'm going to do it in the only way I know how, and that is to be as vicious as a man can be. Thank you.
No problem. All right, fans, you're looking at all decked out there, number one Paul Jones and his two men up there, Mike Rotundo, the Snake Roberts, Dory Funk Jr., as we're going to watch them in a tag team match right here against Bret Hart and Mike Davis. And it's Hart now who will get the match underway against Dory Funk Jr.
Hart's a new guy in this area that's showed a lot of fire and a lot of ability since he's been here. But he's got a champion in his own right, Dory Funk Jr., ex-world heavyweight champion, and a very vicious wrestler, Jake Roberts, in the ring. Bob, I've seen these guys. I've wrestled them many times. And they are great competitors. And I wish Mike Davis and Bret Hart all the luck in the world, and I hope they come off with a big victory.
How you doing, Bob?
All right, Mike, right here, moving over here with us at ringside.
Let's get him a microphone over right here. There's Paul Jones. Paul?
Listen, I think I'll stand over here. I don't want to stand too close to Rotundo because people might think that associate me with him, and I wouldn't want that at all.
That's just fine with me, Mr. Jones.
Bob, I can't hear what he's saying. I'm standing
he
so
far. He said
that's
just fine with him, Paul.
Well, great. Let's at least we agree on one thing.
Dory Funk Jr. with a takedown there, still with the arm now on Bret Hart.
Bret Hart just reversed that.
When we talk about the tag teams, Mike, and I'm not so sure Paul can hear us as we're talking about this, but here are
that's
two
right,
men that
Bob.
He's put together. They are really rough,
so
rugged,
well,
and tough customers up there. Snake Roberts, and look at the snake.
Yeah,
the snake is.
Snake Roberts is
he
a man.
He's like a wild man again when he gets in that ring.
He's got great leverage, Bob. He's 6 feet five, 6 feet 6 inches tall. And he can move very fast.
He misses into the corner. Hart went over to make the tag. The
Mike Davis down. Comes in, throwing punches and going at it.
He's talking about 6'5 tall.
Ooh, a big backdrop since Jacob.
He's a big tall one, but he's not a thin man. Roberts
ooh,
is
nice
a
drop
kick,
right
full the... force of it, right in the face. Davis.
Davis.
Put a couple of heavy blows ooh. On Snake Roberts, and Roberts comes back now.
Roberts
a couple
with another
of blows
cheap
into
shot.
Him. He got Davis from behind, Mike.
Another cheap shot, Bob.
May I say something?
Okay, Paul, right.
I am so excited about my dream contest. Rhonda Manning is supposed to be here tonight in the audience, and I'm excited about it. Even though I hate to get rid of the poster, it's actually, it grows on you. The more the contest, the longer the contest is on. And I tell you, she's one lucky girl.
You should be excited, Jones, to get rid of a picture like that. I'd be glad to get rid of it, too.
I don't want to get rid of it.
Oh, excuse me, I misunderstood.
Now, Paul, you're going to be making that presentation a little later, right? All right, here's Funk now, who has Davis on the mat after that good uppercut forearm blow. But Davis kicked out.
Dory Funk Jr. is throwing those uppercuts.
He can throw a tremendous uppercut, Mike.
I know, Bob. I've been in that ring with him many times, and he can. They're just one tune in the corner right now. Davis with a nice reversal on the turnbuckle. Sends Funk into that turnbuckle. Oh, Davis.
Funk and Roberts, we had talked about Roberts' size.
Mike hesitated right there, and Funk came out with that knee to the stomach. Tags in Roberts.
We're talking about the size of Roberts, Mike, who is a big man, as you say, about
6'5". Mike Davis is about 7 feet in the air, right to that canvas.
Hard suplex. Dory Funk Jr. is also a big man. He and Roberts are about the same size.
You know, Bob, all the wrestlers are so proud of my two men, actually, in my stable.
He just headbutts him out of the ring, Paul.
But actually, Greg Valentine has come to me and asked me at different times for Dory Funk services or Jake the Snake services.
What,
so,
in a tag team match with
sure,
him?
Sure. It seems to be that Piper is doing a lot of running around and tried to hide behind a lot of wrestlers, such as Wahoo McDaniels, Ric Flair, and so on.
I don't think Roddy Piper has to hide behind anyone, Paul Jones. Roddy Piper is a man that I've known since I've been in this area, and I haven't seen him back down from anybody yet, and I don't think he's going to start with Valentine.
Hey, you cover up for Piper. I'm exposing Piper for what he is.
Piper needs no cover up.
Half a man.
Roberts held Davis right there, and Funk with a knee. Holds him up, coming back off of the ropes. Oh, count of two.
Bob, I can testify for Roddy Piper. I saw him in the gym just this afternoon, and I asked him how he felt, and he said he's feeling pretty darn good, and he's training that extra 110% to get his chance back at Valentine because his ear, it was hurt. He had a little bit,
like
a little
you,
bit extra hard.
I'm not so sure he's not going to surprise some people, too. There's no doubt about that. I think he will, Paul, and it might be your guys that are surprised by Roddy Piper.
I don't think so. My guys know
right.
what to expect.
Funk holding him in
I'm
the front
sorry.
Face.
I'm sorry that I ran Rotundo off. I think he was very uncomfortable standing here talking to you, and I figure at any time he figured that I was going to beat him to a pulp, so he thought.
He did a tremendous job out here, Paul, because he has such a tremendous knowledge of wrestling, and he's an outstanding young man who knows a lot about it.
He has a lot of knowledge because he keeps studying. The man learned all his wrestling through a correspondence course.
There goes Roberts. Slammed into the corner there by Hart. Gives him that monkey flip right out of that corner. The snake now with a foot right down across the throat. Rolls over. Hart waiting on him now with a headlock. Polish young man right here may have the snake in trouble. Knee lift.
I will say both these young men are fired up. But I guarantee
look at
you
those uppercuts thing. Coming now from Hart. Roberts with a foot again to the midsection. Tremendous knee lift now from Roberts.
They both realize.
Who is staggering it. Around the ring.
They both realize they're in there with a couple of men, though. They know it. They reach down the bottom of their heart, and they know they're feeling these two men.
Funk now after that tag from Roberts. With a foot, the big foot right to the back now of Hart. Got to whip him again to the ropes. Elbow coming off of the ropes.
Beautiful, beautiful elbow.
Oh, and he got a shoulder up, Paul, at the count of two. And again, he gets a shoulder up. A lot of fight still in Bret Hart.
That Dory Funk does a lot of things with the elbow, and they're all devastating.
What did I tell you? Again. What an uppercut that was. The tag now to Roberts. Here's the snake.
You notice my men switch in and out. There's always a fresh man in there at all times, Bob.
The snake now with Hart high to the air for the slam. Again, is going to help him up off of the mat. High to the air again. Another slam, Paul.
You know, Bob makes me feel good. I see a lot of my great wrestling ability through
look
these
look at that wild swing by Hart.
He's lucky.
Just about out. Still a lot of determination and a lot of fight in him, Paul. He was determined to give it all he could. Rolls Roberts up. Quick count of two, and Roberts kicked out. And what a snake now. Look at him come back. Knee lift. Here's Funk with the elbow again on Hart as he comes off of the mat.
Spinning toe. Let's get
it.
Spinning toe.
Spinning toe right here by Funk. He's going to spin and wrap it again. And Bret Hart again showing tremendous determination.
That kid's probably never felt pain like that before
and
in his whole life.
And he says, yes, Paul.
Oh, that's it.
With that spinning toe hole as Dory Funk Jr. had all of that pressure on it. With the winners, Jake the Snake Roberts, Dory Funk Jr.
I'll tell you what, Bob.
All right, fans.
Let me tell you one thing. Steamboat and Youngblood come out here using that karate, knock my brother out. Well, let me tell you something. We still got the bonnet, we still got the belts, and I never seen a karate man in my life that could beat a wrestler. Of course, I guess that's why we're world champions.
Okay, fans, Jack and Jerry Briscoe. Jerry now, after being out from those blows by Steamboat, and you heard it from Jack Briscoe. Here is Paul Jones. Paul,
okay, this is a big
one. All right, it's your contest, your presentation, Paul.
That's right. And, Bob, I tell you, I'm excited about this, and what a lucky girl Rhonda Manning is. And I tell you, you go ahead and call her out. She's supposed to be here. Yeah. See, I'm excited. I haven't seen her myself.
All right, I understand that Rhonda Manning from Florida is in the audience somewhere. Let's call her out, Paul. Let's see. Rhonda Manning.
Hey, Bob, look at this picture. This will probably be the last time that you and I will see this picture here, for the simple fact is Rhonda Manning is going to win this thing.
Okay. All right.
Hey, listen, let me tell you something right now. You keep your hands off of me. You won the picture, not me. Every girl that wanted to put their hands around me, I wouldn't be able to go out of my house. And I'm going to tell you something else. You don't have to say you're sorry. I'm going to tell you something else. There's thousands of girls that wanted to win this poster right here, and you're the lucky one. Actually, you should show your gratitude. You should be down on your hands and knees showing your gratitude.
Oh, she said she was sorry.
I picked you because you're from Tampa, Florida. I didn't want to pick some redneck around here in this area. What'd you do? Send somebody else's picture in? I have a good mind not to give you this. Look at you. I could have picked a redneck around here if I wanted a redneck.
Paul, she's the winner of your contest. Shouldn't you show her a little more respect?
Come on over here. Now, that's the picture right there.
That's nice.
That's nice. Would you sell it for $5,000?
I'd try to.
You'd try to?
I would.
You wouldn't want to sell that. That's a picture of me. Now, let me tell you something else. You mean to tell me I paid your way all the way here by air
I could have. Don't bother me right now. Don't bother. Shut up. Don't bother me.
Rufus.
Just 1 minute, Paul Jones. Where I come from, you don't talk to the lady like that. You understand that? The lady win the picture, you give it to her.
Look at her.
Where I come from, you don't talk. Get a lady picture, you won it.
Listen.
You wore a tuxedo. You interfered my business and everything. Now just get out of here because this lady right here.
Where I come from, you don't treat a lady like that.
You understand? Where you come from, you're going right back.
Now, wait a minute. Listen,
wait a minute, Paul.
Paul is he's hiding. You don't hide behind a lady, Paul. Paul,
you're
hiding behind the lady, Paul.
You see that? Let me tell you something. If he wasn't out here, I would have knocked him out.
And now he turned around and Rufus got him. And there goes Rufus into the ring after Paul Jones. Jones in his tuck. And Rufus R has got him. Here comes Dory Funk Jr. Here comes Snake Roberts. They all now got Rufus in the ring. And they're ripping and tearing his shirt off. And Jones, Paul Jones, with a big right hand as they hold him, pounds away now at Rufus, being held by Snake, being held by Dory Funk. Here's Paul Jones holding him now. And it's Funk with those uppercuts as they continue, all three of them, to maul Rufus R. Freight Train Jones, the knee lift from Snake Roberts, and he goes down. They kick and they stomp away at him. All three of them now on Rufus R. Jones as they get him again to his feet and hold him up. While two holds him, the other one pounds him. Paul Jones hid behind the lady at first. Then he turned around and Rufus got a blow into him, and then it all broke loose as all three of them continue now to drive, kick, stomp away, and they take his belt. The Snake takes the belt from Rufus, and they're going to whip him with his belt. Here's Rufus in the ring being whipped by Roberts, and here's Bob Orton Jr. in. When Orton comes charging into the ring, all three of them go out. Roberts had the belt, and he was whipping Rufus with his own belt. Now Mike Rotundo comes in. Rufus flat on the mat. Orton now over him, talking to him. And Roberts with that belt takes a big swing now at Rotundo. All right, fans, that's going to do it.